The tech headlines again mention Tim Cook's support for augmented reality. AR is a technology that adds a digital layer on top of the physical world. But Cook's support of this is nothing new.
A significant portion of the population of developed countries will have AR experiences every day. And we will wonder when it does how we lived without it.
And now in 2022 again, he's mentioning AR, and on the other hand, the company is pretty quiet about its development of any AR products.
How's the software going in the mixed reality headset?
I don't know anything about what you're talking about.
So what is Apple up to? In order to answer that, let's take a look at Apple and its history with AR with very surprising information and facts you didn't know. Apple's history with AR starts in 2007 with the launch of the iPhone. Because this was the moment Apple started selling handheld computers with a graphics chip, a camera, and a touchscreen with a way of interacting with visually appealing apps. Funnily enough, the first iPhone launched without the App Store that we know and love today, and with apps such as WinTor, available very soon. But a year later, in 2008, Apple finally launched the first development kit to create iPhone apps. And it was with the launch of one of the first development kits for the iPhone that a company called Lidar actually started working on one of the first public AR apps in 2009 already. I still remember Lidar on my Android device too. It was super basic and it was using GPS and the camera and a gyroscope to show a layer of information on top of the camera feed. Later, they also got functionalities that we use today, such as projecting a digital layer on top of an image. And just to remember, this was back in 2009 already, and it became available on Android too. So Lidar was cross-platform, which is really sick. So we've talked about Lidar, let's go back to Apple now, because according to public information about Apple's acquisitions, it wasn't until 2015 that Apple bought a German company called Metaio, and that would later become part of what we now know as ARKit, which launched 2 years later in 2017. Since 2015, with the acquisition of Metaio, Apple has publicly launched around seven AR-related companies, and among them also hardware manufacturers. So let's now first go back to 2017 when ARKit launched first. Because for anyone who isn't familiar, ARKit is a development tool and a built-in system from Apple that developers can use to enable augmented reality in their apps. So slowly and steadily, developers are getting used to Apple's way of utilizing AR. But first we move from 2017 to 2020. Because that is the first time Apple introduced a key piece of technology for stable AR experiences into the iPad Pro with the launch of the Lidar sensor that you can find right here. It's very small, but it changes everything. Lidar is a depth sensor that's also used in autonomous cars. And that way, a device is much more capable to quickly find surfaces, walls, or objects to attach AR information to. And in 2021, Apple launched another key technology for AR, which is called photogrammetry. It offers a built-in way to scan a physical object and create 3D models out of it, which is insane. In the same year, top Apple analyst Ming-Cho Kuo says that Apple is planning to replace the iPhone with a new device within 10 years. And in this case, he specifically mentioned an AR device. Now we are back in 2022. ARKit is wonderful, and there's a very high probability that you have already seen or used AR at some point during a digital experience. But at the moment, the iPad Pro and the iPhone Pro are still the best AR devices on the market. There's not really a new device yet. If we look at the past, Apple has publicly but very quietly worked on AR already, building up the necessary foundations for maybe a future device. And in this case, the most important foundations are the following. So we have existing AR apps that consumers are using and getting used to. We have an AR infrastructure for developers to easily use AR. We have devices such as the iPad Pro with sensors as a LiDAR and artificial intelligence and great cameras. And there are acquisitions of AR hardware companies and lens companies that Apple can use to maybe create a new type of device. And let's not forget, Apple can also produce entertainment products in-house because they acquired different media companies that are now working on Apple TV Plus shows. They have everything to create really great AR experiences for us as consumers. So that brings us to the future. What will Apple do? Some say Apple is working on a head-worn device, which would be super nice because you would have your hands free for interactions in the physical world. And if that's true, I hope so. I do hope that it will work standalone from the iPhone or Mac. And I also hope that all existing ARKit apps from the iPhone would almost instantly be usable on this AR headset. Because that would mean that this headset would already have hundreds of apps available, and we don't have to wait for developers to create something new. But on the other hand, we already have head-worn AR devices such as the HoloLens, and I do hope that Apple's device will not suck as much as the HoloLens, because that thing is ugly, it's heavy, it has a short battery life, and the optics are so bad, because the colors are not vivid and the field of view is just very, very narrow. I'd rather have Apple working one another year on something that will really blow our minds. But rumors have it that we can already expect something as early as the beginning of next year. So who knows? I hope you learned something new today. It's just a very brief history of what Apple is doing with AR and my personal thoughts about the whole development. Let me know in the comments what your thoughts are about Apple's AR ambitions and the current applications that are available with ARKit. And follow me on LinkedIn for more content about AR and VR and to learn even more. So thank you and bye.